level 2 class, also known as spaghetti. All we need from the audience is one word
buns.
To start. Limes?
Buns!
Buns! Buns. Buns.
Donna, I love how this class just makes me feel, especially my buns.
I know, this is the best stretch I've had all week.
I'm so glad we're roommates. Like, nobody would ever come with me otherwise. They just think I'm too, like, self-centered, which I don't get.
What are those friends of yours? I can't stand them. I'm glad we're spending time together, stretching.
Can you stretch a little closer to me?
Sure. How's that?
You like my buns?
Let me take a second to take a minute. Oh, yeah. I like your buns.
Okay, now, I have to be honest with you. I didn't want you as a roommate just to be a roommate. I love you.
Bridget. I love you too. Wait a second. We love stretching. We love our buns and we love each other.
Oh, my God. Okay. Let's do some more stretches. But over here.
This is gonna change things.
Wait. When you.
We start this little Italian bakery together, and we will stick with it together. Me
yes,
and you.
Yes, we will. We will, Dana. You're such a good friend. Oh, Dana, your pasta. Your pasta is. Like heaven.
My pasta is the better
in
pasta.
Jail.
Of the two of us, mine is better.
No.
Nothing's better than heaven.
No, my pasta is better, but yours is good too.
You have a good gnocchi, but your pasta is not so good. Mine has always been better.
You know what? I'm gonna give you my pasta, and you try it, and you tell me what's better.
Okay, I will try your
pasta.
Try
my pasta.
Okay, just one little noodle.
Yes, Dana.
Okay. My better! Look, I just think we've always had a little bit of a competition.
No, we have not. I'm just better.
Okay. But I think maybe when we have the grandkids come, they will decide. My grandkids versus your grandkids. The Vucciospettis versus the Romanolis.
Dana, but you know, I have 12 grandkids, so of course my father's gonna win.
I only have 8. That is a good point. That is a very good point.
Yes.
Okay, maybe we bring the extended family in.
Sure. How many sisters do you have?
I have 19.
Well, I have 12.
Steve, I'm going to get your order number 12 ready in a second. Do not worry. Man, I love being a fry cook. It's my dream job.
Yeah, so the last two orders, though, totally gave me the wrong thing.
What did you think of? The last two orders were a 5 and a 10, I think.
Nope. Look, it says here we need a 2 with extra sausage, and you gave me just like a plate of grits or something.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. I don't know. That's looked in the menu, said 5 and 10. Right. Well, don't worry. I didn't go to cooking school for nothing.
Yeah.
I'll get this number 12 for you right away.
I don't think you win at all is the thing. You know, it's one thing if it had been just this one time, but it's like every damn time you can't. You're driving me crazy because you can't remember what the orders are.
Well,
hey, we have an order 8 coming in fast.
Order 8, see, I got this one.
Let's
order
see.
8. All right, and this is the order number 12.
That's definitely not. See, again.
That is a bacon cheeseburger.
This isn't anything on our menu. I don't even really know what this is.
That is a bacon cheeseburger.
That's not edible. Nobody, I can't serve this out there.
Well, what's not edible about it?
You're gonna
bacon.
You're gonna put us out of business. You're gonna put us out of business. And
you know what, Steve? I'm just trying to do my job, my dream job, and you're letting my meat burn here. So
I think I'm the fault.
What is that? It looks delicious.
Customers love me.
I don't know.
I don't really know how we ended up in the kitchen. You know what? I'm just gonna get this number 8. 12. Just gonna get ready.
Let's see.
Prove you.
Let's see.
Next customer that shows up, tries it. Prove it to you.
Yeah, this is another one for the bakery.
I'm Star Chef.
Oh, hi, I wanna try that. Oh my god! You're the best fry cook in DC.
I don't know. You're letting them into the kitchen. What?
We're gonna have to have a talk about your cooking school that you I think you falsified.
I graduated summa cum laude from Harvard with a degree in burger making, bun baking, pickle fermenting.
Pickle fermenting. Do you see pickles on our menu?
Well, I'm assuming it's a burger, so of course it had pickles on it.
Yes, ma'am.
I just want, a butter pickle. Delightful.
Oh, gosh, delightful. Hey, that's delightful.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my.
The Vespucci sisters are at it again.
Yes,
two of 19 in the same spot. And where the F is our food?
Oh my god, did you dye your hair on
Yeah.
That's so great.
I'm so sorry I'm so late. I'm here.
Grandmother. Grandmother Vespucci.
I am here. Fun to be with you. I love your little American accent ever since we moved over here.
And you didn't make that up.
No, I'm stuck like this.
You're crazy, Grandma.
Oh, they all say that. So you like my pasta?
Well,
we're in a diet now, but it's
pasta-free.
A diet?
Yes.
That is not Italian, even a little bit.
But we're Americans.
You are American and Italian together. You cannot be gluten-free and Italian at the same time.
Well, you know, it's just that vegetables are new gods.
Okay, what does this mean?
Yes, I mean, the carrots talk to us in the kitchen. Like, I'm better than fried chicken.
She's fine.
A little carrot says this with no mouth.
Can you sit down? I gotta talk to you.
All right.
I gotta share some bad news.
Okay, I'm ready.
Amanda, you're a great roommate.
I know. We have so much fun together, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
Remember when we went shopping? We bought those matching purses. We were all around campus together. I'm glad we're best friends.
I am too, and it's great that we moved in. I gotta tell you this. It's been weighing on me.
Yeah, we're best friends. We're honest with each other.
So,
is it about your hair?
No. What's wrong with my hair?
Much.
Okay. I have some bad news.
Bobby's my hair.
Did Bobby say something about my hair?
I didn't want to tell you. I know you like him so much.
Oh my gosh.
So that was it.
I think that's my favorite attribute. What's wrong with it?
It's just that highlights are a bit much.
Okay, well, point taken, okay? So, so I think you need to move out.
I'm sorry, I told you your hair wasn't cute.
Yeah, you know.
I thought you wanted us to be honest with each other.
That was fine when you could go home, but now this is home and it's not going to work. I don't need brutal honesty in my life.
You know, if I was here when you were dyeing your hair, maybe it wouldn't have looked like that.
All right.
Make that bitch move.
I'm working on it.
Excuse me? Oh my god, Jessica, your hair looks so good.
Oh, thank you.
Bobby and your roommate Bridget's gonna love it.
Thank you. I never thought about coming to beauty school to get my hair done before, but you're doing a great job, I'm sure.
It's going to be great. We're going to do all different types of colors, green, red.
Oh.
Maybe that's some shade of green.
That's a little bit out there.
Yeah, no, but it's like the in thing. You just got to trust me. Beauty school is where all the new trends start.
Well, thank you. Do whatever. If you want to cut it really short, too, that would be fine.
But we can just leave it long. Just, you know, well, you know. I can put it. I can work with it.
You know best, right? You're in school.
We're gonna do this really cool thing where I cut in two different directions.
Oh.
And it kind of like just falls as a spike.
That sounds like a fantastic idea.
And it's gonna work great with the red and green highlights.
Why are there no mirrors in here?
I am the carrots. I speak to you.
What do you want to say, carrot?
I have an important thing for you to do.
Yes.
Do not eat any more of the pasta.
Oh, no.
Oh, grandmother.
I'm so mad. Carrot? Do you
what?
Think we can make it an exception here?
There are no exceptions! Do not eat the pasta!
We're Italians, though.
I don't care! And carrots are everything! They're every culture and nationality!
Okay, I think it's important that carrots swallow us. So.
Okay. Well.
Show me that you really love me. You must do something to. Oh, okay.
You like that, carrot?
Yeah. Can you touch my little green thing on the top?
Welcome, everyone, to the pasta competition of 2018.
I am amazed again.
Today, we have two really amazing competitors. Friends from since they were 3 years old, was it?
Yes.
3 years old, immigrated
years
from
old.
Italy. And our judges, our special judges today, they are 20 grandchildren. Let's give it to them, right? Yeah.
Oh,
no. So, our first chef.
Hi, my name is Nicoletta. I come from Milano, and I make the best.
She makes the best pasta. What's on your dish today?
I'm gonna make some delicious linguine a la carota.
Oh, la carota! And our other chef?
My name is Antonia.
It's Dana.
My middle name, I use when I want to use
it. You don't like Dana. Oh, a little drama.
My
going.
Full name is Dana.
We're best friends.
We are.
Best friends.
Hope
this competition won't get in between you two.
No,
tell us about the dish tonight.
I am going to make not the gnocchi because we know that is just for the peasants. Okay. I am going to make some
linguine. I'm going to make a linguine.
Yes.
You never listen.
I heard you are making the linguine. I will also make the linguine.
Two of the same dishes. Let's get our judges out here. Give them a round of applause, judges. As a reminder, these are the grandchildren of the chefs.
Hey, Grandma.
Hello.
Hey, Mom.
We're on TV, guys.
Hey.
These are the creepier grandchildren.
Hi.
We do not like those too much.
And now the grandchildren will come up and try each dish and comment.
Delicioso, Grandma! Also!
My love, come on, you're just kidding.
Okay. You are so cute.
Terrible!
When he was a baby, he could not stop drinking the mother's milk for too long.
Ah, you are a fat Italian. I'm trying to give them healthy things.
It is a little bit of a secret recipe. Put a little chocolate in the
yes, but no vegetable
it.
There. Everyone dying from your family.
They are vegan. Okay, two more, come on.
Yes. We do this every semester, so it's a lot of fun, and they do such a good job. We're going to get ready to introduce the highest level that you can, well, not highest, we have advanced levels, but this is the highest level within our five levels, so this is level 5. And the cream of the crop, the bread and the butter, give it up, slow clap for...
From you, not a food, just a word.
Contusion.
Contusion?
Contusion.
Contusion. Thank you.
Okay.
Contusion.
So once when I was 9 years old, we always played hide and go seek at midnight at my grandma's house. And so me and my cousins were running around, and I was so excited that I was about to get to home base that I turned around to make sure my cousin wasn't about to get me. I turned back around and there was a big mailbox there and I ran right into it. And I had a big gash down my head, blood was just spurting everywhere. But I kept running because I didn't want to be it. So I touched home base.
There was one time when I was in high school that I ran into my own mailbox at home with my car. And I thought the best thing to do was, being an artist myself, was to go inside my house and grab my acrylics and to paint over the gash in my father's Explorer. Needless to say, I thought for a few weeks that nobody noticed. But a couple weeks ago, my dad brought up that one time that I painted the car rather badly, thinking that I covered up my tracks. Of course, everybody...
Speaking of making big dents in cars, I had an experience where I was telling my mom that women were probably not as good drivers as men. Oh. And then, as I proceeded to pull away as I was dropping her off from BWI Airport, I scraped the entire side of a Chrysler Concorde. And I had to go into the airport terminal, go to my mother and say, "Hi, I destroyed your car." And she was like, "Michael, don't fuck with me." And I'm like, "I'm not." And then I had a very slow drive home with a giant dash in my car.
Mom, so I know you just got me that new car, and I know you said if I wrecked it within the first week that I would have to pay for it, but what if somebody else wrecked it, my car?
Well, it's completely wrecked. If we walk outside and we look at it, the right front is gone.
It's all gone, but I didn't do anything. I was just sitting in the car in the parking lot, and then it just got wrecked. I don't know what happened.
Okay, did you get a number? Sorry, I assumed it was a woman. That was it.
You're not woke, but it's so it was a woman, right? But I didn't know I was supposed to get her number, so no, I didn't do that. I got her name though, it was Ashley. She was really cute.
Yeah. How old was she?
Ooh, she was probably a senior, something 17 or 18.
You can track down her high school.
Well, I'm just like with me, I'm sure. Because I was in the high school parking lot. I think she's a popular girl.
I'm starting to get the idea.
Yeah. So we can fix. You
I
can pay.
I think what we'll do is we'll drive over. Well, we'll take my other car.
Okay.
And we'll drive over to the parking lot and we'll find Ashley.
All right. Cool.
Yeah.
We're gonna do that, Ashley, when we find her.
I can remember some things we used to do when I was your age.
Oh, Mom, you're so dumb! Great.
We could TP your car.
Okay.
That might be an old idea.
I haven't seen anyone TP your car before, but
yeah.
That sounds awesome.
We could write on it with lipstick.
Yes. You could key it. You could just go up there and slash it.
I'm sure there are more modern ideas that we can use.
Let's be dope. Let's, we could go up to her car and smash it with your car and leave a note that's like, later, bitches.
Michael. I appreciate you inviting me to play this game of hide and seek. After the last one, I'm a little apprehensive about being found and or locating another place to hide.
I didn't mean to punch you. I was just really excited.
You were walking straight at me with your fist, like this. I was wearing bright yellow.
Yeah. It's all the boxer training I've had. That's how I approach people. I don't know. I'm sorry.
Okay. We've been friends long enough that I think you mean it when you say you're sorry.
I do.
So if I go look for another place, we're gonna be cool, right?
Yeah. I'm gonna find you.
No, you're not.
I'm not looking.
Don't look at me.
I'll find you.
Can't find me.
Okay, I'm coming. I'm gonna find you.
Please don't come.
Where are you? I hear you. Oh my God!
No!
What you doing there, Travis?
Obviously, I'm painting. We went to Home Depot. We bought this awful color of peach.
What you doing, Travis?
Yeah.
You're painting, Travis.
I happen to like watching you paint.
Don't know where we're going with this, but keep going. I'm intrigued. This is more fun than painting.
You seem to have some sort of swing in you. I'm not really adept at, you know, what exactly you do when you paint, but I like the way you do it.
Are you getting hot?
Always. Yep, oh, you missed a spot there.
Why don't you come here and help me?
Well, I hear that it's all in the hips. So what you do is you grab the shaft right here.
Oh, okay.
And you go up real high, just like that. Oh, you want to make sure all the crannies are up there, and then you want to come down low. Oh, go up a little bit.
Oh, no, hang on a second. I just got to stay down for a minute.
Oh, okay. All right, not quite ready for that.
No.
I'll let you relax a little bit. So yeah, that's how you do it. Just painting the walls peach, as they say.
This is exactly what our therapist was talking about.
Hey, I was listening.
Fuck lesbian bed death. Peach painting. I'm gonna take you out of the super later.
In our purple super room.
Let's go get a dog.
Who needs a dog when you can have a cat?
Another one? But what about Ralphie?
After the crash I got in.
Oh my god, Titan and Pink! Wait.
Oh my god.
Love
you.
Ladies,
bitch.
Look at yourselves. We're living in a modern day. You can drive where you want to and be safe doing it.
Yeah,
clear. Shut up, birdies.
Oh, Susan, you're always bringing the crowd down. Just
yeah.
Accept it.
I think it's important that we just accept our place.
I agree.
No higher, just right here.
Yeah. People see me on the highway, they're like,
you agree with me, Vonda?
I'm sorry. I'm actually with Susan on this one. We're all highly trained mechanics, and there's no need for us to continue picturing the stereotypes, and we're all very knowledgeable about cars. Chassis and transmissions and such.
Yeah. Third wave feminism!
Completely beside the point.
Yeah.
When you're driving, and you're a lady,
that's
you
real feminine.
Certain deference.
True.
It's about looking
fabulous
and
while
you,
driving.
And you can, with one hand, hold the wheel, and with the other,
you can feel the male gaze. You have difference in the male gaze.
It's not my fault that my nails are glittery and sometimes the sun reflects off them and it blinds me and I kill people.
Hey, Ashley. Oh, my God, hey, whoa. I didn't even know you were here. So I was wondering, do you know? Thank God. So
I'm not so sure when you hear what I have to say.
Tell me. Go ahead, spill it.
It was my daughter's car.
Yeah, I ran into her car because all the cool kids have their cars ready too. It's sort of like a badge of honor. Okay, come with me. Okay, so. Here's my 2014 Honda Civic. Do you see how it's mostly blue, but then it's in completely sideswiped, and it's a swath of gray?
Yeah, that's like steel gray.
It is, because it's steel.
And
of course.
I
yes.
knew I wasn't woke.
Not woke enough.
Not woke enough.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
Are you saying that you want me to do this to your car as well? I get it.
Will you?
Oh, I can see it in your eyes, yeah.
I just want my daughter to think that I'm really a modern mother.
A modern mother, a modern woman. I get it. I get it. Let me,
yeah.
I brought these bats. Okay, so is this your Volvo?
Yes.
This is your Volvo?
This is my
car. Okay, because I can't just like vandalize any car. I mean, to us, but to the law, it is technically a felony.
I'm here and I'm watching.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, are you eliminating over there?
We're gonna do it. Okay. One, two, bam! Boom! 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 Do you want the mirror half hanging off, or do you want it all the way off? Because I can go ahead and I can complete it.
Oh man, this Volvo is woke as fuck! Oh my gosh, Mom, you're so cool! Her car is so dope and woke!
I didn't think you'd ever say that about me!
Dude. Oh my god, is that my Volvo?
We have to come to the hospital this time. I have a real problem.
To say the least, the left side of my face and this massive contusion definitely agree with you.
You had a really good hiding space, though. I mean, that was, I was just so excited that you found that little nook.
Yeah, it's actually a bunker. I had scouted out beforehand, I don't even know. How you are capable of punching through that door, I don't know.
My strength, I don't know it well. But the doctor should be in here soon, though, I think. But we can take care of this.
Oh, hey, how you doing, sport? What's up?
how did you say this happened? We were playing hide and seek, and I found her. And I was really excited when I found her, and I do what you do, man.
You know, I'd be lying if I said that hasn't happened to me once or twice. You okay?
Doctor, I found her chart.
Nurse Meriwether, come over here.
Oh, yeah.
I can't see the chart with your hand cowered like that. Oh, you're the best!
Georgia Peach Classic!
Oh my god, do you have your outfit
picked up? I do.
Do you want to see?
Yes. Wow, that is see-through.
I know. I
want to
talk about your outfit.
Yeah?
I don't think it's see-through enough.
Is it because of the plaid over the see-through? I just wanted to stick to, like, tradition.
No, they're not gonna like you there.
Oh.
I'm gonna take the plaid off.
Oh,
okay,
okay, yeah.
Let everyone see
peel
who
it
you are.
Down.
If you're gonna be at the golf range, hurry up and golf. Are you keeping your clothes here?
Yes!
Yes! Hurry up, let's go!
We need to be able to feel free when we swing. The air. Okay, it's 2018. Can we now just show a little skin?
I'm not commenting on your choice of outfits. I just want you to hurry up.
I could go.
Take your time.
If you'd stop yelling at me. And I could focus.
I'm here for you.
Thank you. I need you behind me to do this.
Both don't hit themselves!
Oh my god. I'm gonna admit I'm a little self-conscious being totally naked and also yelled at.
We need to own our bodies, okay? And we need to start taking men's sports back, like golf.
Yeah, I think we definitely could show men what's up if we play their sports naked.
Fumes coming out of the back of the car. That really, like, it's vapor.
Without context, that doesn't make any sense.
We had a really big talk with Jimmy, though. Jimmy! Jimmy, get your ass in here!
Is that a mace? Why are you swinging a mace around?
Okay, so...
This neighborhood...
That's the bitch who hit my Volvo!
Oh. Oh, but isn't that the thing that you want?
Scapegoat bitches.
I have to stop hanging out in high school parking lots!
Oh my god.
Welcome to Home Depot. This is like your third visit this month for paint. Literally running out of colors.
It sure is, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean,
do you have a recommendation? Maybe old version?
Yeah, I mean, right now, the variant color is fugue.
What the fuck is fugue?
It's a mystery. But it is selling like hotcakes. You guys are gonna love it.
I'm open to this, are you?
Fugue. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. All right, let's do it. Okay, so after this, we go to the animal shelter, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. That's needs
a I steer it myself.
I mean, isn't this what couples do?
Do you guys, like, need some new rollers?
Oh.
I think we do.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Just
this
hold
is me too. Excuse me. What are you doing?
That's the help. No! We have a family together!
Don't call
Look at that nonsense, honey. Everyone's in an open relationship now in DC!
We are not in an open relationship, goddammit!
No, it's not open anymore.
Yeah, we're just looking for, like, nude-colored clothes, or clothes we could be naked in, or clothes that are just, like, not clothes, you know, that don't cover anything.
I know what you're talking about. We have just the right thing for you guys. It came in last week. You will be the first to own it. Let me grab it.
So like a nude?
Yes.
Like a...
It's called Air. Put it on.
It's so light, it must be very expensive.
It's very expensive. The material, it's made of oxygen and hydrogen and just lots of, like, carbon dioxide.
Hurry up in those dressing rooms, I want to try on my air!
Shut up, man! Hold on, there's plenty of air to go around.
But it's all very expensive!
Yes, there's not. There's only these two, so you better buy them quick.
Oh, yes! I get it. I'm very hip, very athletic, very, like, taking things back from men.
Yeah,
it looks
like
a big girl. Oh.
Yeah. My therapist was right. He's taking all my energy and punching up cars now that it's cool. This is so much better. I don't even need a baseball bat or anything. Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh.
Mm-hmm. You're doing a great job, buddy.
It's like the cool hit thing, like...
No, I've seen the other cars around.
Yeah.
We live on a block full of beat-up cars.
That's true.
I'm sorry, are baseball bats not woke anymore?
No, man, it's all with your hands now.
Okay, I hear TPing cars is the thing to do. There's one over there.
Let's go. All
right.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good. Gabby. No, it's okay.
Grandma here's gonna try something new.
Oh, you gave her some chimes. Beautiful. I was gonna try some cars to be cool with my friends, but.
This is what the kids are doing now.
Grandma, you're a little too eager. Who am I to say no to a face like that?
You left me unprotected.
Volvo. Volvo.
Stand up high. But don't fall over.
Volvo.
Oh, I think Volvo is the new hip
word.
The bus got so crowded now that everyone's cars are broken.
Does anyone got a bat?
Ice cream.
We could kind of like trash the Metro car. I mean, we can trash the bus.
I really do hate the Metro.
It's the worst.
Late capitalism isn't as fun as they said it was going to be.
Generosity. Cool. Over here. What is it? Someone you really, really love.
It just shout out. Don't be so love people.
It's a very sad section.
Well, over here. What quality of someone you love?
Creative.
Generous. I'm gonna try this side again. One quality of somebody you love.
Trust.
Trustworthy. Generous.
Creative.
Thank you all.
I made this sculpture just for you in my kiln.
Oh, it's so creative.
I was hoping you would say that.
Is that us?
That's us together.
And what is that we're doing?
We're windsurfing.
Oh, I see it now. Okay.
Be careful, don't break it.
Ooh, we're still on that.
I was hoping that if I made you enough ceramics, it would help us get past that.
I mean, it was college. It was one frat party.
I made you a castle, too.
Oh, wow. And are those us on the turrets?
Yes. Yes, you're the knight up there.
Okay.
And I'm the court jester.
No, man, you should totally break up with David. His pottery's so derivative.
Show me what you got.
This is a flower vase.
That is a shapely vase.
Yeah, it's voluptuous. Just break up with him at the kegger tonight. You know, you and I should be together.
I don't know. I think I'm kind of getting over Potter.
What?
It's just like, as an art form, it's too real.
So I understand you're looking for a relationship with someone who's interested in new art forms.
Yeah, no, I mean, some good interpretation, but I'm just not getting the zeitgeist. I don't really love it.
We call this modern chakra dance, and I think you and I would have a great relationship.
I think I'm looking for someone with more of like a Western influence in their interpretive dance. So the chakra thing's sort of a non-starter.
Oh, you Americans are so unsophisticated.
Charlene, yes. I wouldn't mind if you stopped for a minute, but so here's the thing. I have very good news.
Yes.
The very news. You are coming to Juilliard. You are going to start our first ever chakra dance major. And I almost got fired from admissions because I wasn't recruiting unique enough people. And now they're going to make me head of admissions.
Oh,
because
my God,
I found you.
Oh, no.
I cannot think. Oh, I got you a car, darling.
exactly the one I wanted.
I also got your friend a car, and your mom, and your husband.
Oh my God, you're so generous!
I was just like, I woke up this morning, and I'm like, I'm gonna buy six people a car.
I just don't understand where you get all this money and this time and just your spirit of all things.
Frankly,
what's the secret?
I'm in a lot of debt. I've promised most of my organs should I die in an untimely way and be brain dead, so I got some money that way, but I just wanted to know, to make sure that people like you know how important you are in my life. I really need you to know that I'm generous.
Hey, so I know I put dibs on it, but, like, my kidney's not doing great, so I'm just wondering if we could, like, get it early.
Mark, okay, look, I feel like I've still got some life in me, you know? Like, I made a deal.
If you were, like, really generous, I'm just saying, like, you have two.
I do have two, you're right. I'm sorry.
So if I could have both, that would just be, like, great.
Well, okay,
I just want a backup. I think this is where they are. it'd be helpful if I could have a spare.
No, I'm sorry. If you can't pay for this dialysis, we're gonna just have to remove it and.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm just gonna wrap it up in a little bag. I'm just gonna put it over here.
Okay,
health
sure.
Insurance is expensive.
It really is.
So I just want to thank you for agreeing to be part of what can only be described as the most revolutionary side, medical science. I know it's a lot, but we're gonna do a brain swap. I need one other person to agree to the study. That'll do.
You did pay me a lot of money.
I did.
And I've already spent it giving cars to people I kind of like. So, yeah, I guess this is what I signed up for, you know? Tell me a little bit about the... Hi!
Well, you're going to get a lot of potassium. You're literally going to have a monkey's brain.
Okay.
The good news is, well, you won't see this, but the monkey will have your brain, and this will test my theory that if you do that,
monkey,
it will have interesting results.
I don't know. If you're going to have my brain... I just want you to know. Okay, well, credit's really important. Okay, so, like, you're gonna wanna give people lots of bananas. Don't give them to them. Okay, because you're gonna end up in a science experiment. Really? That's what I'm gonna be?
What's gonna happen?
Wow, I've never been in a relationship with a monkey as generous as you. Can I make a smoothie out of it? Whoa, dump it in there. I'm just thinking that maybe we could spice it up a little bit. With kale or something like that? No? Just the bananas.
Jenny, I wish you would just stop throwing poop at me around the house. Worse, this is not. I'm concerned. The kids are getting some bad habits from you now. Yeah, they. Jenny's up in a tree. She's dangling. It's in the crux of a branch, and she's just hanging. It seems like you have one skill here. You can climb up and get her. Oh, okay. Get us some protein. Then could you save our daughter? Okay. Well. Could you at least get a job? It's been really hard. You had a lot of debt from your previous iteration.
So I am so excited for us to be interviewed on CNN. My experiment has been a success. You still have all the movement and emotional qualities of a monkey, but
you have Jenny's brain.
Yes, I'm still very generous, although...
Oh my gosh!
Christiane Amanpour, thank you for having me.
I'm so excited.
Yes.
So, really just let me lead off with this why. Why did you do this?
great
Chris, Christiana, if you could just stop her, she's kind of going long.
And then, after my Harvard Medical School, I thought, how am I going to be better than all these other overeducated pricks? I know.
So sorry,
I'll switch
Chris,
brains.
You can't say prick.
And that's how I came to the idea.
So this is all about being better than your classmates.
I see how that sounds.
Then I would say, it's about medical science. It's about leaving the world.
Ooh, she seems to be filibustering again, Christiana. If you could just keep her in her seat.
But then I found it. Okay.
Yeah. So, I'm sorry.
You have great staff here.
They're great. Yeah. But my real issue here is, look, you seem to be doing great, but somewhere out there, there's a woman who has half of the money.
Yeah. The other half fell on the floor.
Okay, Mac said, back behind the tree, behind the old schoolhouse. Did you find it yet? Oh, Dad wouldn't lie to us, right? Well, he did before, I don't know. No, but this time he's not joking us around, right?
Dad, this.
So where all did you look?
Behind the tree?
Yeah, I looked behind the tree, like, it just went around the whole tree. There's supposed to be like a little knot hole or something, but it's not here.
How do you know that's the right tree?
Oh.
Let me see this. Great one, honey. This time they're gonna be out for days looking.
They trust us so much.
Dad and Mom love us, right? They just send us on like a fun treasure exploration adventure.
I love how we barely tolerate them.
I know. We can send them off on any old mindless adventure. And they'll just do it. Because they're idiots.
You know, I'm having a hard time trusting them lately. I've heard some things.
You take that back.
No.
You take that back.
It's true.
You take that back.
I'm glad we finally pitted them against each other, too.
I know, it's like five monkeys fight.
Christopher, when they're old and they're writing up their will, they're gonna remember that I was the one who believed.
Yeah.
It's so funny that they think we're going to leave them money. I'm donating all of my money to research.
I perfectly measured out my retirement so that I die the day it runs out.
Jacob?
So this week, I sent my children into a minefield. I was like, why would I pay anyone to see if they were mines when I birthed these children, you know?
An heir and a spare.
An heir and a spare, and then a few more for the minefield.
As the saying goes.
Oh, I'm so glad that we found each other, because some of my other friends just don't understand, you know?
People are so judgmental, thank God for Craigslist.
Oh, everybody is getting fake treasure maps! I've decided I need to be more like Jimmy Kimmel and have parents do cool things to their children. That sounds amazing! I think the newest thing in my magazine should be fake maps and dangerous traps for your children. Yeah. At the end of the path, instead of treasure, there's like a mine. Exactly! You get me, Gail! I do! It'll be so fun. And then the parents will just donate to charity!
Yes. Like, did you have a college fund for your child? Well, that child blew up in a mine, so now you have money for charity!
For children who really need it!
Yes!
Finally!
Oh God. Oh, it's so tiring.
I
come up with new ideas!
Your genius is exhausted!
Do you have any water on Parch?
Oh, water?
Oh, thank you.
Has hibiscus and gin.
That's where the ideas come from.
So friendly.
I'm thinking, get her a job young, then she can be a millionaire like me!
Yes! Two.
Friendship, Gail, you know the cheers.
It's a sweet friendship. I just got choked up because this time I really felt it here. Friendship.
showered with my clothes. Oh, I feel so refreshed. Hi, Timmy. You have a funny lip.
The disabled children's.
Oh, like you.
Of course, here's $100 bill.
And you can come work on our set.
There's money on the ground, child. You can roll around and pick it up.
I can't roll around very well.
That sounds like Darren at work.
Oh, I am so sorry, Oprah. You found my son. I sent him to a landmine.
I told you, it'd be hilarious. To friendship.
You know, I just think friendship is overrated.
Oh, completely.
I'm so glad that we can all just, like, be in the same room, but just kind of
hate each other?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a neutral.
Yeah.
It's like I don't dislike, I don't like, there's no points in any column.
Well, you're a better person than me then. I'm all about dislike.
Just a generic click, you know. No real, like, objective, but no worldview.
Oh, your beard is scruffy.
I think it's ugly.
It's funny that we spend time together doing this as if we were friends. But it's more like a fear of loneliness. A crippling, crippling fear of loneliness.
You didn't have to say it.
Loud!
We all knew it.
The elephant's just right there.
Thanks so much, John, for just putting it out there. Now we have to address it.
You know, if it's out in the room, then I'm not gonna, like, stand off in the corner anymore. Like, we're... Just address it.
Oh, this is really hard for me, you guys.
Just address it.
Okay.
Hey, what's up?
Oh, no, yeah. I mean, there's an elephant,
yeah.
And then there's an elephant. You
yeah.
Know?
Yeah. See, you guys all gotta hang together. Can't be a lone wolf, huh?
He does kind of make it look cool.
Yeah.
Shit.
Why don't you go stand next to him and see what cool it looks?
I'll report back.
Whoa. What are you doing?
Bum a smoke?
Yeah, I'm almost done with that one.
Oh. Super generous.
So, are those your friends?
They're people, I know.
We hate each other.
You like your sign language or something.
Take it, I guess.
Is this, lone wolves are hanging out?
Yeah, lone wolves. Got it.
Lone wolves together.
Kind of like a pack of individuals.
Yeah, like-minded, but not strongly affiliated individuals.
I don't know what it's like to be. Just
honest. Sorry, guys, I'm over here now.
Now that he's gone, like, I really miss all of his qualities. He's got some great qualities, guys.
I mean, generous. Most of them get on my nerves, but yeah, I miss that little fucker.
I can hear you, and it's kind of blurring me back.
You still look terrible.
You know, you shouldn't listen to them. All they want to do is suck all your energy away and detract from who you are as a person.
Look, it sucks that you don't wear deodorant, and it sucks that your shoes are, like, from 4 seasons ago, but we miss you, all right? We miss you!
Sounds like they think you stink.
Look, Dabs, okay? I know you're lone wolves, and, like, you've heard that my whole life, and I get it, but I need someone to take me to the father-daughter dance. I appreciate you saving a little bit for me. That's how I know you love me, because you gave me a vacation.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'll give you the keys to the car.
I'm 12, but okay.
And we'll just see how it goes for you.
Look, all the other little kids only have one dad, and they have a dad coming with them to the father-daughter dance, and I just feel like it's weird I have two dads. But I can't get a single dad to go with me.
I'll go with you.
But I'm gonna stand outside and look through the window.
That's probably the most generous offer you've ever made to me.
Okay.
Mr. Robinson, I appreciate that you danced with me since my dad wasn't here, but he's out the window, so.
I see that. Yeah.
I think we can dance through
that. Come on now, don't be awkward. Dance. It's dad and daughter dance time.
Honey, has that teacher ever tried to dance with you?
I know, I just don't want to his office.
Do they normally have a glass separating? Or is he like a former felon?
He wanted me to go to a Catholic school.
Your grammar's great, though.
Everything on my computer is fine.
Dad, I'm glad you're here. I have to be honest. I'm here. Let me get this all out. You raised me to be an amazing physician. I think I kind of took a left turn. All of it was that, I mean, you know, I've been in the news because I did this whole innovative groundbreaking surgery, but it might have been kind of like going too far. And it was all just because I realized that all I've ever wanted is your approval. And I just want to know, do I have it?
That's a real thinker.
What? Everything I did was because I just wanted you proud of me.
I'm just really turning it over in my head. On one hand, undeniably intelligent, genius, smart. On the other hand, maybe a sin against God.
It's like, I'm your only child, and mom died in childbirth. I'm literally the center. Oh my God, what is my life? I've done so many different things, and I just really wanted you to be proud of me.
My daughter.
Yeah.
And I think that we can work with maybe just calling on the phone every week or so. And we'll start from there.
Mm-hmm. Let's
go from a sort of blank slate.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we can put this whole monkey brain swap behind us.
I would love
that. It's funny, we don't normally get two of them in the confessional, but I can hear you both, I guess.
Thank you for seeing us on such short notice.
Could you just like one at a time? I can't see you, so it's hard to track.
Yeah. Let me sum up. Raised by overbearing, demanding father, never good enough, being groundbreaking doctor, went too far.
I'm sorry, you can't see my hand, but it is down on the floor.
That's
you say groundbreaking, but went too far. Could you elaborate?
I switched a human brain and a monkey brain.
That's too far.
So, father, like, what if you really like the way you're living your life, but you think it could be bad?
I'm gonna need some more specifics, my child.
It's like, what if I have kids, but I hate them. So I just kind of do stuff for my own amusement.
So,
and I love it. If it makes you happy,
could you?
It
I'd just like some
bad.
More specifics on amusement. Like,
Hey, sorry.
Oh, we got another. Great.
I think
it's
private, but okay.
I'm sorry, I might have killed a monkey.
Half-brained animals unite! Great crow, you are here! Dolphin! And the chicken! We will take over what the humans tried to take from us! Half of our brain!
They're so smart! How did this happen?
Here's a human now!
Kill him!
Give me help! Oh, it's gone too far! Again! I'll eat your brains!
Who's next?
Buffett! We will rule with a
human, but I just want to tell you, that I don't approve of what my daughter did, so I'm right there with you.
You're really doing a lot of weird things at the Brookfield Zoo these days.
I know, right? I mean, I came to see some penguins, but these zoo exhibits these days are just kind of...
Eat their flesh!
Workshops. This is super fun to do. There's free workshops everywhere in the city. You can sign up and do it yourself. If you would please donate, we are a nonprofit, we are mission driven. The donations help support this theater to keep it open during the showcase days, as well as the free workshops. We also now do free workshops for any DCPS school. Thank you all so much. Have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Thanks.